Welcome to the channel, guys. So today we're doing something a little different. I'm off on an adventure to pick up a new hot rod. A friend of mine's stepdad, he wants this big ugly hunk of junk for some reason. And he's got me a nice little hot rod sitting by his property that I've been kind of wanting since I was a little kid. So it'd be nice to finally have one. So unfortunately, I can't video on the way to and from his place, but I will show everything once I get there. This truck, I've had it for about 2 years. It's a 1997 K2500 5.7 4L80 truck. It's not a bad little truck, but it's not my style, and it's time for it to go. Let's go. So, there's the GMC off to its new home. I'm not real sure on what I'm allowed to record here, so I gotta ask before I go any further. Okay, so tell me about the car again.
It's a 1967 Rambler Rogue. The internet says it was competition for the Mustang and the Camaro small blocks. It's a 290 V8 automatic shift in the floor. Has a race cam and a hydromatic racing transmission from the factory, which is obsolete now, but in its day, it was top of the line.
Well,
bucket seats.
Boy, it's a cool little car.
Dual pipes.
The trunk, but you don't know what.
So yeah, this is the replacement for the truck. Pretty cool. Oh, this is cool. It's supposed to be a 290, but it's a 67. So I think it's a 343, but I won't know until I can get under the car. AMC's, they cast their cubic displacement in the side of the block, which is kind of a handy feature. Okay, we got a battery in it.
Battery up, starter turbo. Yep. The ignition.
This little cap board you have down, see if it starts.
Yeah. I think it'll fire right up. It ain't got no gas at all in the tank.
Yeah, I figure I'll throw a cap. It'll, if it fires, it'll sputter first.
You may need more to cap. No shit. I told you it's gonna run.
Oh, that's cool.
Gas in the tank, buddy.
Yeah.
This little car is a good little car.
I think it is. It didn't even, like, this less work than I thought it was gonna be.
I told you we'd pour gas in it and it would run. Yeah, you didn't believe me.
I'm sorry for ever doubting you. You're the first person that's told me that to be true.
It come out true. But I drove it in here.
Yeah.
The rest of them drug them in and pretended like they drove them in.
Right.
Unless you're me, and then I drove it halfway home, blew it up, and then drug it in. Yeah. I drove it home. That happened. That didn't actually happen. I drove it home. That little pickup over
it's
here.
It's even got power steering fluid in it.
This little pickup over here you see me messing with?
Yeah.
I bought it in Bolivar with a blown head gasket and didn't know it had a blown head gasket. I started dilapening in it. It was on a repo line, and cold weather and the gauge would go up about hot and I pull over and it's low on water and I filled it up with water three or four times and I just give up and kept driving. And I drove it from Bolivar. I think it's on the other
side. That's right. Just check and make sure they got no rotten fuel lines.
I wouldn't check the lines.
Yeah.
I'm sure they're rotten. Two old rocks.
But I don't know.
I got a funnel if we had a metal cutter. We have to find a pair of dykes. The best funnel you can get for what you're doing right there.
One.
I'd say after you poured some gas in there and mix it, if it would fire it up, like burn it out.
Go ahead and hit it.
Unless it leaked, it's got gas in it.
Oh, got oil?
Yeah, oil.
See,
hard to catch it over with. They're probably quieting down when it runs, and it ain't been started until new. That's a pretty good quick start for 10 years
that
ago.
I'm Kyle, I don't start that quick, and I started every couple
I would have
months.
Told you, we know we'd have to clean the points and shit. Old man put all that on it new just before I got it. So
I was planning on bringing a set of points for it.
The Ford fuel filters that look like a bell with two ends on them. You cut the end off of that fuel filter, and it's got a little quarter-inch hole sticking out so you can fill carburetor.
I've actually, on Amazon, I bought this little pack of funnels. Years fires up better than a brand new car.
Yeah.
Stays on longer than the Mini Cooper on some cold mornings.
Our Mini Cooper's got she drives a 2017 Cooper S.
Hold the glass back a little bit, keep the thing in your hand.
Oh.
You don't want that by your face, it backfires. Ain't smoke, no smoke coming out the back or nothing, if you know.
Saves me a lot of work.
The lifters are quieting down now.
I'm planning on running this thing around with the boys next summer.
Ready? You may not have enough gas in the tank. It could have broken line underneath of it.
What I'm doing is this vent tube right here, you can actually fill this and fill the float bowl while you're waiting on the mechanical fuel pump to fill everything. This will let the car stay running a little longer. And for those of you fuel injection guys that have seen me do my Bluetooth fuel lines, this is how I've done it. You fill the float bowls on a carburetor, the motor will run for a few minutes.
Here's what you're stinking in it.
I've got it.
This.
I got quite a bit in there, so let's see. Oh, the keys on the dash.
You got a whip.
Yep. Don't feel like it's pulling it. The good news is I've got video proof it runs. This bad boy didn't even hesitate.
I got quite a bit of fuel in the bowl. I'm gonna see if it'll pull the gear. Thank you.
Hi.
I might have to pull it out.
I figured we'd have to. I can't do that.
What?
I can't do that. I four kids.
With you?
No.
Oh.
Well, shit.
Motor.
A motor.
No, I mean none of that wreck.
A box. Not the oil pan.
Well, it's at least hauling itself out of here.
Oh, I have to.
Alright, so here she is in all her glory. The 67 AMC Rogue 290 car. We've been dealing on this truck and car for 6 months and finally came to a deal. I'm gonna get this thing washed up. So, I'm going to call it good on the video here. Subscribe for more. You're going to be seeing a lot of gold dust here in the next few videos. Remember the other socials, TikTok, Facebook, all 5-Sense3 Racing. So, TikTok is Ethanol 5-Sense3, but, you know. Till next time.